importantly, how you got there. Where the instant obliterates the past. So, first group. Yeah. What part of speech is it? What? Tell me your answer and how you got there. So, Lisa, Nancy, Kate, Lynn, anyone?
For the meaning, is it?
You can start with either the... Well, what part of speech is it? Yeah, I'm hearing from others a verb, but yeah, it is a verb, yeah. Okay, what do you think it means?
It's like rub off the ablation.
Yeah, just your phrase of it, rub out.
You rub out.
You rub out something. Delete. Exactly. That is exactly right. How did you get there?
Very quickly to rub out.
Not so much quickly as thoroughly, completely. Obliterate is complete. Doesn't have to be quick. Often it is, you know, with a bomb or something that totally destroys, but it could be, you know, an Israeli bulldozer comes in and obliterates a Palestinian village and they take 2 weeks to do it. It doesn't necessarily have to be quick. The thing is, it's total. Total deletion.
For my meaning, is it whatever how long they've been set up, but as soon as the latest one come up, is it they destroy it very quickly, they pass.
That's right, that's what he's talking about, isn't it? In the media, the next story totally destroys the earlier story. Yeah, that's how it's being used in the broader. That is the ultimate result in this instance,
yeah.
But it's more that the instant destroys the past, and therefore we forget. The forgetting is a consequence; it's true, but the actual verb means like destroys. Yeah. Did you get close to that in your guessing?
Yeah.
Did anybody already know the word? No. Fairly big, long, fat words that are not very common. Completely destroy. It's got to have to be something about destroy, rub out, delete. Yeah. Okay, deemed. What did you guys think? Dilhani, what did you think?
It's a verb.
Yeah, and what you identify, what form of verb too? What form
it's
of verb?
It's a passive.
It's a passive, isn't it? Yeah. And what did you think through and conclude about this word?
It seems, the meaning that seems, or...
Yes, or...
Regards?
Yeah, that's interesting. Very similar to Hitomi and Taiwan. Taiwan, you said...
You got
yeah, regarded as, you just need an as. It's regarded as boring. And Hitomi, you had seemed, yeah. It seems to someone. Yeah. So you could have it's thought of as, it's regarded as, it's considered to be boring. Yeah. It's a mental verb, isn't it? Sorry, Nancy.
My question is when we give the answer for this kind of question,
yeah.
Should we give the same tense? Of the
world. I'm not too worried about that, but it's good to stay consistent.
If there's the verb, so
that's
it's
right.
Past time.
Put it in the past.
Okay.
Yeah, no, that's a good point. I'm not going to take points off if you don't, but it's just good practice. It's like sort of translation that you get a closer, more accurate. Yeah.
Any reason related to rule number 8, the because the deem and seem look similar.
Right. I doubt it because roots don't kind of work. Often the first word of a root, the first sound of a root is important to Dean and Seam. They would be coming from different roots. I think that's just an accident. Now, if we look at it, the crisis hasn't, I'll just go a little bit further with this one, the crisis has not passed. It may well be worsening, but, and this gives you the clue, that things are getting worse, but now it's something boring. Now, he's just been talking about news stories and how people forget things or lose interest. So it's about what people think of the thing, isn't it? It's got something, it's a mental verb about what people think of the crisis. That's, we can tell this from just the logic of the context. But notice how we have to go back a bit. In fact, not just one sentence. We really have to go back to the crisis has not passed. It may well be worsening, but now it's deemed boring. It's just an example where you have to go back actually two sentences. And really, you've got to go back further in a way, because it fits with his whole argument. These things happen, and then we think they're boring another day later. So really, you've got to get the sense of almost that whole paragraph, or even the two or three paragraphs where you've been arguing that, to really be able to guess that word. It's just an example of, remember how I said, sometimes you have to not just look at the immediate sentence. You have, it's better often to go back, and in this case, back and back and back, and look at the whole argument. That gives you a clue. The whole argument really is a clue to that word. You see that that's what's going on here?
The whole sentence is meaning, say, even the crisis is not past, but the people they thought is already past and make it.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah.
The whole meaning.
That's it, that's right. The whole meaning, and in fact the whole meaning of the argument needs to be used to really get that word clear. Yeah. Okay, linger. Nimike, everybody else has run away, so I guess it's up to you, isn't it?
Is that a verb?
Yes, it is a verb. Right. We no longer linger on great issues. And again, really, you know, the meaning is kind of connected with this whole argument here. So, what did you guys guess? Is it a material verb? Is it a physical verb or a mental verb? It's mental, isn't it? Yeah, it's a bit like deemed, mental verb. We no longer...
Stay.
Stay, yeah. Linger is stay. Care is a fair guess, yeah. But linger, when you linger somewhere, you just hang around, you stay. So the news cycle moves very, very quickly, and we don't stay on important issues, move on to the next one. So again, it's connected with this whole argument, what he's been talking about here. We no longer linger on great issues, we neither concentrate nor cogitate. What did you guys think up front about cogitate?
It means
like
cognition, when you're thinking or deeply.
Yeah. Did you say cognition or recognition?
Cognition,
that's right.
Cogitate.
Yeah.
It looks like cognition.
Yeah, good. Right, so here you use similarity to another English word. You the noun. Yes.
Concentrate or deep thinking, correct.
Yeah. Now in this case, we neither do this nor this. Now those two things are going to be similar, aren't they? The fact that you say neither this nor this, there's a high probability those two things are what we call parallel. They're going to be the same quality. And we've just been told concentrate, so it's a mental verb, and it's going to be something quite similar to concentrate. So yeah, deep thinking is a good guess, and you use this other strategy of, okay, cognition, knowing the noun form. And then how did you know cognition?
When you have a cognitive development,
Yeah, right, you know the adjective too, bravo. But, okay, so you've got a good vocabulary there, you already know that. Anybody else already know the word cognition? You should all know it because... You should all know it because... It's on your bloody sheet there, isn't it? Yeah? And I've been using the word several times. Verbs of inert perception and cognition. Verb perception, seeing, smelling, hearing something, and cognition, thinking. So there, we're really just recycling that. And we're just looking here at the verb form. Yeah. Yeah, so, cogitate, think, exactly. Think deeply, think deeply. And look, the other reason we can sort of tell is both of these, linger and cogitate, kind of help each other because we no longer da-da-da, we need a da-da-da. Both those two things, again, going to probably, is kind of, we could guess they're probably repeating the same sort of idea, isn't it? It's just a bit of repetition for emphasis and stress. So once you figure out one, it's likely that the other verb is going to be meaning a similar thing. And in fact, that's what we get. They both mean stay on a topic and think deeply about it. So look for this kind of parallelism. Sometimes you look for contrast. Words like but, you know, however, can indicate contrast of one idea with another. You've got to look for these kind of clues. Yeah. All right, bonus point, question. You guys at the back managed to figure this out. What is it?
It's longer and linger.
Yes.
And concentrate and cogitate.
Yeah.
They both start like in the same...
Similar sound.
Similar sound?
Yes.
So it's
alliteration, yeah. The k and the or. We've talked about this before, alliteration. It's just a little poetic device, isn't it? Now, it's not poetry. The opposite of poetry, when something is not poetry, it's prose. Prose can be like your pediatrics article, non-fiction, or it can be a bit of creative writing like that, like Philip Adams. They're both prose. Fiction and non-fiction, that's prose. So you can still, that is often in poetry, but it can also work in prose as well. And it just adds a kind of musicality, and we often remember phrases that have a bit of alliteration in them.
And the answer would be, he used alliteration.
Yeah. Just, I would tend to, when you're writing about something like that, any article, and you're reviewing or analysing, right in the present tense, he uses alliteration. It's not totally wrong to use the past, but the convention, the most common practice, is present tense. So, when you're doing your critical review on the paediatrics article, you're analysing it, you're evaluating it, right in the present tense. The article, the study suffers from this particular problem. Research demonstrates many strengths. Just write it in your present tense. That's the general convention for criticism or analysis. It doesn't matter if it's of an artistic piece or a scientific piece, present tense.
Last one. Concentrate and
cogitate
is alliteration, but longer and
linger
is also rhyming, but still alliteration.
Okay, that's an interesting point. Rhyme, not lime, sound like lime, lemon and lime.
Okay,
rhyme.
Rhyme. I thought they are rhyming.
Yeah.
Rhyme.
Rhyme.
Yeah. I thought that's rhyming.
Yeah. Okay, look, it's okay. Longer. Okay, there's a country town in South Australia, not far away, called Maiponga. Longer, Maiponga. Ponga, that is a rhyme. Because it's got the same vowel. That is a focal. Well, that's a rhyme. Okay. Linga, longa. It's true. You're picking up alliteration, but you're now focusing on this other sound effect. It's not quite a full rhyme. It's what we call half rhyme. Because the vowel is different, but the rest is the same. And it's pretty close, isn't it? Linger longer, that's half rhyme. Mm-hmm. So if we're analysing this, really, your best answer would be it's both alliteration and half rhyme. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So then you get not a bonus point, you win the Nobel Prize for Literature if you can answer that. That's very, very technical. Certainly that sort of thing, you know, year 12 English.
If you don't try,
oh, if you don't, no, that's just a bonus question. So if you've lost the point somewhere else and you answer that, you pick up the point, yeah?
But if you answer wrong, will we take off the point as well?
No, no, that's right. Okay. You can only win points. Yeah, that's our point of the bonus. You can only win. There's a lot going on in Philip Adams. We could, I just picked there are more than six questions really, aren't there? Because four's got three and six has got three. I don't know, 10 questions. You could ask about 30 questions of this piece. There's a lot going on in that.
And
in
final test,
yeah.
It would be
as similar.
If I want to say, as easy as this one.
It'll be similar to that.
Or harder.
Philip Adams is sometimes used in your assessments, and other writers are used who have similar sorts of styles and similar level of vocabulary and complexity and similar kind of playing around and using techniques like this and, you know, yeah, quite similar.
Final exam, it would be harder than this.
No, like this. I think I said earlier to others, you might not have been here, That was a past diploma assessment. We just stopped using it because we've got so many other ones.
The teacher said at the beginning of the term I teach you the easiest.
Yeah.
But by getting to the end of the term, I give you the hardest one, which is getting close to.
Right. No, this is typical difficulty level. Yeah. How do you find, or just ask you, how does this feel, this level?
Getting hard.
Not very easy for me.
Is it?
Getting very good? Easy.
Not very easy.
Not very easy. Yeah. I mean, I
no, not very easy.
No, I expect it is quite challenging.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. I think I might have said that, you know, our weekly diet in year 12 was Philip Adams, our English teacher used to give us. So native speaker, top English class, you know, Philip Adams, Philip Adams, Philip Adams, to learn all these tricks and techniques and so on. Sure. So, yeah, you know, you're at a pretty high level dealing with this. The last one, remember I said the last one, there'll be some difficult questions to see if you can get level 5. Those questions, it is actually Philip Adams' piece, and those questions are very similar to what I sort of put my hat on and thought, okay, a year 12. Write some questions for a native year 12. That's like a level 5. So if you can answer a lot of those, then, you know, similar to what a year 12 would answer, that's a level 5. So these questions aren't set at year 12 level. A year 12 could answer all of those quite easily.
How many minutes?
You get an hour to answer.
What do you recommend? What is the strategy? We have to read the question first and then...
You will be given this for quarter of an hour. You'll be given an article for quarter of an hour, no questions. Just to read. And you can note and you can mark it as much as you like. Right, then you get the question. I go through them just to make sure you're clear on the question. Then you've got an hour to answer. That's the pattern. So it's like the whole thing's about an hour and 20 minutes. What I suggest you do, have a look on the Moodle, that link, that second link, the first link I don't think works quite correctly, to Philip Adams, you'll get his latest new ones. I won't be using those for assessments, but then you want to get used to this style and this vocabulary and this complexity, I've worked through some of those. I think it's about a dozen of them. That's one of you. I'd say that'd be about your best practice. Also, the next four people are also very similar writers, and some of those people, we've taken assessment pieces from them as well.
And in the Moodle? In the Moodle.
Under reading. That's right. Okay, guys, we might leave it there. So,
you have a nice
day. Won't see you tomorrow. We'll be sitting in front of in a panel instead.
Today, we want to.
We'll see you on Monday. Yes.
But I forgot my